Hi viewers, என்னோட வீடியோஸ் பிடிச்சிருந்தா லைக் பண்ணுங்க. இது வரைக்கும் சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணாதவங்க சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுங்க. ரைட் சைடுல இருக்கக்கூடிய பெல் பட்டனை கிளிக் பண்ணுங்க. நீங்க கொடுக்கிற ஒவ்வொரு லைக்ஸும் நான் நிறைய வீடியோஸ் அப்லோட் பண்றதுக்கு மோட்டிவேட்டா இருக்கும். சோ லைக், ஷேர், சப்ஸ்கிரைப் அண்ட் கமெண்ட் மை வீடியோ.
Hi children. Good morning ma'am. What is today's topic?
Children, today we are going to discuss about Citizen and Citizenship Act 1955.
Ma'am, who is a citizen?
Citizen is a person of a country who is entitled to enjoy all the legal rights and privileges granted by a state and is obligated to obey its laws and to fulfill its duties.
Ma'am, what is citizenship?
Citizenship is the status given to the citizens which provide them the right to legally live in a country as long as they want.
Ma'am, who is the first citizen of our country, India?
President is the first citizen of India.
Ma'am, how can we get citizenship?
Let us watch a video about this in detail.
Class 8, Term 1, Unit 2, Citizens and Citizenship. Let me start with the learning objectives. Students acquire knowledge in meaning, definition of citizens and citizenship, the constitutional provisions of India, acquisition and termination of Indian citizenship, nature of overseas citizenship of India, rights and responsibilities of a citizen. Civics is the study of government. The word citizen is derived from the Latin word civis, which means resident of a city-state of ancient Rome. After the disappearance of city-state system, it has been used to mean a member of the state. The citizens of a state enjoy full civil and political rights. Let us see the meaning of citizen and citizenship. Citizen is a person of a country who is entitled to enjoy all the legal rights and privileges granted by a state and is obligated to obey its laws and to fulfill its duties. Citizenship is the status given to the citizens which provide them the right to legally live in a country as long as they want. Types of citizen. There are two types of citizens. Number one, natural citizen. Number two, naturalized citizen. Natural citizens are the citizens by birth. Naturalized citizens are those who acquires citizenship. Indian Citizenship Act 1955. This act gives the provisions for the acquisition and termination of Indian citizenship. List of amendments made in Citizenship Act 1955. The First Amendment Act in the year 1986 with respect to a person born in India. So before 1986, the Act says if any person take birth in India, then he will be eligible for Indian citizenship. But this Amendment Act changed this provision that the person's birth should be in India and one of his or her parent should be an Indian to get the citizenship. Citizenship Amendment Act 1992 with respect to discrimination against women. Before 1992, if any person needs citizenship, then his or her father should be an Indian citizen without considering the mother. Amendment Act 1992 ended this discrimination against women and said that either of the parent, father or mother, should be an Indian citizen. Citizenship Amendment Act 2003 deals with illegal migrant. Amendment Act 2003 stopped the illegal migrants from acquiring citizenship on the basis of registration and naturalization. Citizenship Amendment Act 2005 deals with overseas citizen of India. The Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 was passed by the Parliament of India on 11th December 2019. It amended the Citizenship Act 1955 by providing a pass to Indian citizenship for illegal migrants of Hindu, Sikhs, Buddhist, Jain, Parsi and Christian religious minorities who had fled persecution from Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan before December 2014. Muslims from those countries were not given such eligibility. Now let me explain about the Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. Amendment means changes made in the provisions of Citizenship Act 1955. Persecution. It means misbehaving or violence or discriminating or unfair treatment of a person or a group, especially on the basis of their religion, political belief, races. Illegal migrants. Illegal migrants are those who enter into a country without valid travel documents or passport, or if he or she has passport but has exceeded the time limit permitted to stay in the country. Now let us see about the neighboring countries of India. During 12th to 20th centuries, due to religious persecution in Iran, the Parsis people of Iran migrated into India. See our neighboring countries like Afghanistan, Pakistan, China, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Burma, that is Myanmar. People from these countries were migrated into India. In the year 1947, partition happened between India and Pakistan. That time, more than 1 crore people migrated to each other country. Similarly, in the year 1959 to 1960, annexation of Tibet by China. So, many Tibetans shifted to India. Bangladesh Freedom Movement in the year 1960 to 1971. Due to this war, many people migrated into India. Similarly, in the year 1979, that is Soviet-Afghan War, many Afghans also migrated into India.
In 1980 to 2000, due to Sri Lankan Civil War, many Sri Lankan Tamils came to India. In 2015 to 2017, Rohingyas of Myanmar migrated into India.
According to the census report 2001, more number of migrants in India are from Bangladesh and Pakistan. Citizenship in India is dealt in two places. One is Indian Constitution and the other is Indian Citizenship Act 1955. The provisions in our Constitution was helpful for our grandparents and forefathers. This Amendment Act changes the definition of illegal migrants and it says that before 31st December 2014, any person who came to India in any ways, and if they are from Afghanistan, Pakistan and Bangladesh, and if they belong to these six communities, Hindus, Sikhs, Buddhists, Jains, Parsis, Christians, are not called as a illegal migrants. This act changes in the process of acquiring citizenship. If you are coming from Pakistan and willing to take Indian citizenship in India, then you have to stay in India for 11 years or have to do government services to get citizenship. But this act changed this provision from the period of 11 years to 5 years for these three countries belonging to six communities. Let us see about the acquisition of citizenship. Number 1. By birth, section 3. By descent, section 4. By registration, section 5. By naturalization, section 6. By incorporation of territory, section 7. We are going to see in detail about these. Acquiring citizenship by birth, section 3. Born in India, the place of birth should be in India. First point, from 26 January 1950 to before 1st July 1987, if a person born in India automatically gets Indian citizenship irrespective of his or her parents, Indian or non-Indian. This is applicable till 1987 because during this period, people from neighboring countries come in India, and if their child born in India, then they get Indian citizenship automatically. It creates a problematic issue. That's why after Amendment Act 1986 has given that on or after 1st July 1987, if a person born in India gets citizenship only if either of us or parent is a citizen of India at the time of his birth. Then after Amendment Act 2003, if a person born in India on or after 3rd December 2004 will get citizenship, or one of his or her parent is a citizen of India and the other is not a illegal migrant at the time of birth. Illegal migrant, section 21B of Indian Citizenship Act means a person comes to India without valid passport and travel document, or if he has passport but he has exceeded the time permitted to stay in India. Now we are going to see about acquiring citizenship by descent, section 4. Born outside India, descent means by your parents or grandparents, your relationship to any country. First point, a person born outside India on or after 26 January 1950 but before 10th December 1992 gets Indian citizenship if his or her father was a citizen of India at the time of birth. This is applicable till 1992 because after that Amendment Act came into existence which says about gender equality. So, after the Amendment Act 1992, this provision was made. A person born outside India on or after 10th December 1992 gets citizenship if either of his or her parent, that is father or mother, is a citizen of India at the time of birth. This is applicable till December 2004 only. From December 3, 2004 onwards, a person born outside India shall not be a citizen by descent unless his or her birth is registered at an Indian consulate within 1 year of the date of birth. Now we are going to see about the acquisition of citizenship by registration, section 5. Person of Indian origin. Let me give the meaning. Is called as a overseas Indians or non-resident Indians, or the people of Indian birth, descent or origin who live outside the Republic of India is called as a person of Indian origin. Now, a person of Indian origin who is ordinarily resident in any country or place outside undivided India. Undivided India means Akhand Bharat or British India. A person of Indian origin who is ordinarily resident in India for 7 years before making an application for registration. A person who is married to a citizen of India and is ordinarily resident in India for 7 years before making an application for registration, they can get citizenship. The next is acquiring citizenship by naturalization, section 6. The central government on application grant a certificate of naturalization to a person if he is not a citizen of any country where citizens of India are prevented from becoming subjects or citizen of that country. Then a citizen of any country renounce means cancel the citizenship of that country. Then he or she has either resided in India or been in the service of government in India throughout the period of 12 months can get citizenship. The central government may on application grant a certificate of naturalization to any person he or she is a good character and has an adequate knowledge of language specified in 8th schedule to the constitution, at presently 22 languages. Acquisition of citizenship by incorporation of territory, section 7. If any foreign territory becomes a part of India, for example Pondicherry, the government of India specifies the person who among the people of the territory shall be the citizen of India. Such person becomes the citizens of India from the notified date. For example, when Pondicherry became a part of India, the government of India issued the citizenship Pondicherry order 1962. Loss of citizenship, renunciation, section 8, termination, section 9, deprivation, section 10. Part 2 of the Constitution of India, Article 5 to 11, prescribes the three ways of losing citizenship. Number 1 is renunciation, that is making declaration. It is a voluntary act when a person acquiring the citizenship of another country gives up his or her Indian citizenship. Section 9, termination, takes place by the operation of law. When an Indian citizen voluntarily by own acquires the citizenship of another country, he or she automatically ceases, means stop to be an Indian citizen. Section 10, deprivation, is a compulsory termination. The citizenship is deprived on the basis of an order of the government of India in cases if a person involved in fraud, false representation or being disloyal to the constitution. Nationality and citizenship. Nationality is the status of belonging to a particular nation by origin, that is birth. It's an ethnic and racial concept. Nationality of a person cannot be changed. Citizenship is granted to an individual by the government of the country when he or she complies with the legal formalities. Citizenship can be changed. Single citizenship. Our Indian constitution provides for only single citizenship, that is the Indian citizenship. But federal states like USA, United States of America and Switzerland has dual citizenship, that is double citizenship, namely national citizenship and the state citizenship. In India, all citizens irrespective of the state in which they are born or reside enjoy the same political and civil rights of the citizenship all over the country. Overseas citizenship of India. Non-resident Indian, see NRI, an Indian citizen who is residing outside India and holds an Indian passport is called as NRI. The next one, person of Indian origin. We discussed this before itself. PIO, a person whose ancestor was an Indian national and who is presently holding another country citizenship other than Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, Afghanistan, China and Nepal. This scheme was rescinded with effect from January 9, 2015. Then OCI, Overseas Citizen of India card holder. It is an immigration status permitting a foreign citizen of India origin to live and work in the Republic of India indefinitely, except the citizen of Pakistan and Bangladesh. There are no voting rights for an OCI card holder. Now let us see the rights and duties of citizen. We are the citizen, so we have some rights and duties. Our constitution confers the following rights for the citizen of India. Fundamental rights, then right to vote in the election to the Lok Sabha and the state legislature. So the eligible age to vote is 18. Right to hold certain public offices. Right to become the member of the parliament and state legislature. According to 42nd amendment of our constitution, a set of fundamental duties are prescribed for all citizens of India. For example, paying tax honestly, respecting the rights, beliefs and opinions of others, defending, that is safeguarding our country, respect and obey state and local laws and so on. Alien and immigrant are two terms that are used to refer non-nationals of a country. Let us see who is alien. Alien refers to all non-citizens or non-nationals residing in a country. For example, foreign students, tourists. Immigrant refers to alien who has been granted the right to reside and work permanently without restriction in a particular country. To be a good citizen, we should have some qualities. What are they? Number one, we should be loyalty to the constitution, obey laws, contributes to society and community and performs civic duty, quality of goodness and justice, respecting diversity. So these are the qualities a good citizen should possess. Global citizenship. Global citizenship is an idea that everyone, no matter where they live, is a part of a worldwide community rather than as a citizen of particular nation or place. All people have rights and civic responsibilities. It is fundamental in enabling young people to access and participate in shaping the modern society. Overseas Indians Day, Parvasi Bharatiya Divas, sponsored by Ministry of External Affairs of Government of India, is celebrated once in every 2 years to mark the contributions of overseas Indian community in the development of India. The day, that is January 9, commemorates the arrival of Mahatma Gandhi in India from South Africa. Now let us come to the conclusion that our Constitution of India has introduced single citizenship. It provides uniform rights for the people of India. It promotes the feeling of fraternity, that is brotherhood, and unity among them to build an integrated Indian nation.
Are you ready for the quiz time?
Questions for the quiz. First question. Which act deals with the provisions for the acquisition and termination of Indian citizenship? Second one. When was the amendment for overseas citizen of India made? Third one. When was the Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 passed? Fourth one. When was the China-Tibet War happened? Fifth one. Mention the section that deals with acquisition of citizenship by naturalization. Sixth one. When is Parvazi Bhartiya Diwas Day? Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe my channel for more videos. It will be useful for your competitive exams.